rolling down a backwoods Tennessee byway. One arm on the wheel, holding my lover with the other. A sweet, soft southern thrill. Worked hard all week, got a little jingle on a Tennessee Saturday night. Couldn't feel better, I'm together with my Dixieland delight. Spend my dollar, park in a holler beneath the mountain moonlight. Hold her up tight, make a little loving, a little turn of dubbing on a Mason-Dixon night. It's my life, oh so right, my Dixieland delight. Tail buck deer munching on clover, red-tailed hawk sitting on a limb, chubby old groundhog, croaking bullfrog, free as a feeling in the wind. Homegrown country girl, gonna give me a whirl on a Tennessee Saturday night. Lucky as a seven, living in heaven with my Dixieland delight. Spend my dollars, park in a holler beneath the mountain moonlight. Hold her up tight, make a little loving, a little turtle doving on a Mason-Dixon night. It's my life.
The last day of Cloth Hockey for 2013-14. And starting off with a whistle, we are playing Bryn Mawr for, it looks like the 3 and 4 seeds playing. And 1 and 2 going to play a little later on. This will be the Kloss last game of the season. It's February 7th, 2014. And for those wondering where that Verizon tape is from yesterday, well, unfortunately, I got the first two periods, then I was switching batteries, and the hard drive crashed on my other camera. And I think it is probably long gone. Wow, look at that shot coming down the alley. Emily out of control, coming right at us. Gonna turn. And we are playing Bryn Mawr. I think we've owned them this year. We'll see if we own them and go out winners today. I'm not sure how good this camera is. It is my backup, but we're going to try it. And basically, yesterday, the hard drive did crash. I can fix the camera by reformatting, but I'm going to lose all the data. So as I speak right now, I've found a program that might be able to extract at least the first two periods. And if so, we'll put it up. If not, I give you 1,000 apologies and blame the technology, because that really sucks that we missed that, especially for the seniors. Uh-oh. Oh, beautiful shot. That was an incredible shot. Wow. We're going to slide down to, let's get behind this goalie, because I think we're going to score here quick.
Oh,
yeah. Back to the inferior rink here with all the body parts smashed into the glass. But anyway, that is really sad that we missed yesterday's finish. It was a great game. End up 8-8. Very thrilling playing in the Verizon Center. And, of course, Dummy here loses and breaks the camera. But there'll be bigger disappointments in life than that, so we're not going to worry too much about it. And we're going to finish out with a win today against Black and Yellow. Looks like everybody on the cloth was able to suit up today, just like yesterday. Uh-oh, trouble. Just missed. Ouch. Ouch. Good shot. For some reason, things look a little darker in this screen. I hope that it doesn't come out that way. All right, moving down, moving down. Ooh, saw a breakaway. Man, this glass is disgusting. I guess we're towards the end of our season. It's just to be expected. Interesting thing from last night. Did you see how much snow they, when they have those TV timeouts, how much snow they took off the ice? That'd be a cool job if you're in high school or something, being a ice cleaner at the Verizon Center. These girls could do it. They skate. They can handle a shovel, I'm sure. Oh, what a great shot. Good work, ladies. Good work. Keep firing away, ladies. Keep firing away. Wow. Bring it back up there, ladies. Come on. I hear a lot of cowbells next door. You hear about all these cowbells, and you see that Christopher Walken at the Verizon up on the screen asking for more cowbell. And my question to you all is, how many of you even know what that means, more cowbell? Probably, now your parents may know about it. Great save down there, Casey, sacrificing her body again for the good of the cloth. I don't know if I ever told you a story about what the cloth is, but at the risk of repeating myself, I'm not going to tell, because I think I did tell you about what the cloth actually is. Piece of tartan. It is a piece of cloth. But tell you what, why don't we take a break? Next break. Wow. Casey, out of control. This truly is a brick house. Look how fast she's coming in. Wow. Emily. Ugh. I'm glad there's a wall between me and the ice, otherwise she's going to hit me at about 80 miles an hour. I would not like that. Casey is out of control down there. Wow. We're going to show you a little blurb from what cowbell truly is. If you Googled it, or if you search for it on YouTube, you find it. Or we'll look at it right here. So that's why you have Christopher Walken talking about more cowbell. And that is a great, great band, Blue Oyster Cult. Wow. Amazing stops down there. If your team name was The Storm, like Kristen Falsinelli's volleyball team, you would have all your volleyball videos introduced, every one of them, with I Am The Storm, a great song by the cowbell band, Blue Oyster Cult. Ladies, new line. Cloth, let's bring it down here now. Cloth, come on. We've had enough twiddling down on their end. Let's play down here now. Here we come. Oh, I can feel the vibrations of the board. Can't get the fighting though. Oh, good defense by Black. Someone's asking for more cowbell because I can hear
another face-off.
Come on, Cloth, get the puck up on this end of the ice. I'm impatient. I want to see some goals. And I want to see white goals, not black. Puck in net. Here we go. The lonely life of a goalie. But Casey chose that lonely life. Here we go. Good job. Good shot. Good shot, ladies. Keep it up. One of them, as we know, is gonna fall. Emily! Good shot. Oh, she's stopping everything today, but that's not going to last. When you see the clouds blacken, remember, you've been warned. No shelter from the fierce wind, because I am the storm. Oh, there's our black cloud. Let's storm one in there. Come on. Of course, Jessica in the goal in a fight. Here we go. Here we go, Cloth. To get a time check here in a minute. Wow, time is flying. 3:52 left. There it is. Good shot, good attempt. All right, Clark, nice job. Wow. Here come real close players. Ref, keep your arm down. You're losing friends. Stinky, stinky. Gonna come work on Casey here. Gonna pelt her. Casey just stopping everything down there tonight. Nice. I wish they would institute full contact girls hockey so you could check into the walls. I'd love to see that. Tell you what, this is a heck of a game. Bryn Mawr came out today like they're on fire, as did the Cloth, but I've never seen Bryn Mawr playing this well. We've owned them this season. Owned them. That's a penalty, isn't it? Certainly looked like one. Oh, gonna report it. Somebody's going into detention. I think. Nope, guess not. Well, that's crusty. Looks like she's going to take someone's head off with that stick. Here we go. Ooh. How the heck did we score 8 goals yesterday at the Verizon Center? And we got 1:50 to go in the first, and we are in a scoreless deadlock right now. Come on, ladies. That puck smells the back of the net. Here we go. In soccer, that would be a trip in the box. Oh, he called something. Soccer, that's a trip in the box and a free shot. What is it going to be here? Is someone going into the detention box? It appears one of their girls has been bad and has been set to detention. There she is. She's being scolded by the referee. Ooh, that was a miss. So, black and yellow is playing one man down right now. Or shall we say one woman down. Here we go. Nice shot. Tried to lift it. Good idea. Good idea. Keep it coming, girls. Keep it coming. We've got 114 to go. We got 142 in the penalty. So we're going to finish this period with an advantage. And the clock says 110. So we're going to finish out one man up. Let's get one in now. Come on. Ouch. What? Perfect. And that score comes at the 32 seconds left in the period. Cloth jump out to a 1-0 lead, and they take advantage of the penalty. Nice job, ladies. Found a chair to stand on now for the second period. The interesting thing is, I've got two average batteries for... Oh, God, this one's flashing yellow already. This one's running out of gas, too. Jessica, you got to have your batteries charged when I steal your camera. Well, I have one more battery left on this one. I'm going to let this one run until it completely dies, so I may miss a couple seconds of the action, and, boy, I hope it lasts the whole game. Because the big one is at home trying to extract data from the old camera. Am I boring you yet? As I look around, I'd love to be standing. That would be a great place to view the action from if we could cut that net out.
Nelson's here.
Hey, I saw Nelson. Mr. Abreu is here. So we're going to run this thing till the camera goes dry.
Is that your old camera?
It's Jessica's camera. Where is she in now? What? She's bound and determined to score. Here we go. Tell you what, folks, you can't feel it, but if this camera had feel around, you would be shaking. Oh, beautiful shot. Again? Oh, get it? That was a nice shot. All those shots were nice, but that first one was so hard, it almost shook me off my perch on this chair. Here we go again. Wow. You can hear it, I guess. That is loud. And again, when the picture just cuts out automatically, it means the battery went dead. We're at the 12:50 mark. Casey manning the net and minding it quite well. Wow. Here we go. You know, it's interesting, you stand about a foot and a half higher up on a chair, and unless you got 7 foot tall hockey players, here we go. Emily adds to her claw. guess what? I got cut off mid-sentence. That's when the battery died, just after Emily scored. So, Emily, I'm glad we captured that goal before the battery went dead. We got a new battery in here now that I made sure was charged, but it isn't the extra large one. So hopefully it's got 40 minutes of power into it. But hey, at least I'm gauging my time and know what I need tomorrow, do tomorrow, than all-day volleyball tournament down at St. Mary's College. But the Cloth is leading. Now you wonder, is it the Cloth are leading or the Cloth is leading? Because Cloth is singular, but Cloth as a team over there is plural. The Cloth. Is it the Cloth is leading or the Cloth are leading? There's something to ponder, ladies. Take that back to your English teacher. Mrs. So-and-so, I don't know the English teacher's name. When we're talking about our team collectively as the Cloth, is it singular or is it plural? Oh! Oh, got a bad bounce there. And you saw her try to read it, and it was floating in the air, and just couldn't bring it down because it was floating. Otherwise, that was goal number three for sure. Wow, look at that defense close. Oh, that wasn't nice, knocking her off her skates. That's very unladylike. Wow, great shot. Wow. But I'll tell you what, that was very, very, very unladylike. And I'm going to show that to one of your counselors. And you're going to have to discuss that in, I guess, religion class, maybe? About how you have, how you treat your fellow competitors. Knocking them into the wall and then stealing the puck and coming down and almost scoring. That's not nice. Ladies, ladies of the academy, you are ladies. We are not brutes out there. We are fine Christian women. We are not thugs. We are not violent. We are not brutish. We are lotus. We are sweet. We eat lots of ice cream and pasta, as we saw last night. Actually, I think it was a lot of the brothers here that were just pigs. Last night, it was not growing up with boys in our household, other than when I was growing up, but recently, I never could fathom what boys eat like. I mean, keep your hands away from their mouth. They'd probably get sucked in. They'd eat your hand. I mean, they didn't stop. I wish I had a camera. Just eating machines. Nice job, Casey. And we're at 9:50 to go in the second. Cloth leading 2-0. They're screaming, but they're screaming to no avail because Casey has snuffed another one out. You ever heard the story of the baseball player, the mighty Casey? Well, guess what? Our Casey on the Cloth is mighty, but she's not anything like the mighty Casey of baseball fame, because that mighty Casey strikes out. It's like they just scored the first goal of the season or something. No big deal. When they shoot about 60 times on net, the odds are one of them's going in, Casey, so don't sweat it. It's 2-1. 9:27 to go. Not a problem. The load has got your back, Casey. Well, for some reason, that was not a score. They were cheering like it was. I mean, you saw the celebration. Did my eyes deceive me? He who has eyes but does not see, that was me. I saw a celebration that was it had to be a goal. Maybe they're celebrating because it was almost a goal. Because the scoreboard says 2-0. So, Casey, nice job. .8:30 to go in the second. Is that Emily retrieving that puck? I'm taping without my glasses on. Emily thought she was a baseball player sliding into second. This is hockey. Get your game straight there, Casey. I mean, Emily, sorry about that. Line change, and we're coming down on this end. Clock says 8:39 left in the second. And a shot. That was not the right place to hit that defense. Here comes the cloth on the attack. Where's that puck? If you were watching last night, you saw the Capitals, those pros, passing to each other using the walls. You know what that means? That's studying you do in math class, learning about angles. See how it pays off in real life? At least it did for those guys. They were just dumb hockey players in school. They learned the angles, and now they have know how to apply them when they're making millions of dollars doing it. Where's the puck? It's all by itself. That's a thing of art right there, isn't it? Beautiful. Just a work of art coming down the ice. We ain't got no stinking figure skaters out here. Nonetheless, works of art. Just a different type of art. Physical art. Not dainty. Not playing music. Not acting like a ballerina. Sorry, I'm not videotaping any stinking figure skating ever. Wow, tremendous. Tremendous. I don't understand how you got that in from that angle. I mean, from there to there, we will take it. Beautiful. Look at it again. 3-1. No figure skating in my future for videotaping. And as for the Olympics, I think the Americans ought to pull out of that place. They just killed, those commies killed something like 7,000 dogs in the past couple weeks while they putting on the Olympics on. You drink orange-colored water that's just like sewage. No pillows. Food's horrible, accommodations suck. They're not treating people with respect. Respecting others' opinions. Of course, that's something I never do. Because I believe there's only one way, my way. Nonetheless, I think the protests, have the Olympics, the American Olympians, pull out and protest. Stand up for those poor defenseless dogs. I was mistaken on the score. It's 3-0, not 3-1. Sorry about that, folks. We got 5:30 to go in the second period. Bryn Mawr's putting up a tough game today. Things hold true to form. They play us tough for about a period and a half, and then we pull away from them. At least that's, hey, that's the facts, Jack. Just missed. Toying with them. Where's that puck? Lost it. There it is. Blacks changed their line. Fly up now at the other end. 420 to go. Casey is doing the splits today. Hope she stretched out before the match today. I'm sure she did. She's getting a workout down there. I mean, they've been pelting her with shots. That was going to be a tough angle. I'm glad you didn't shoot. I would have missed it. What is she? What is she?
She's a brick house. She's mighty, mighty. Just letting it all hang out. She's a brick house. I like Lady Stack. That's a fact. Ain't holding nothing back. Oh, she's a brick house.
Coming around, centered. Oh, you know how close that was? That was really close, just missed. Good job. There it is. Just missed. Good work, ladies. Keep it up. Nice work. Keep shooting. Keep piling away. Keep pounding away. That puck tumble's funny, doesn't it? You know, imagine getting hit with one of those sticks in your hand. Oh, wait a minute, that's why they got gloves. That would hurt. That would really hurt. All right, Mr. Official, get out of the way. I want to see you jump up on the wall like I saw the guys doing last night. And again, they're getting paid $200,000 a year to jump up on walls. And those guys are a couple hundred pounds coming at them at 200 miles an hour on skates. I'd be up on the wall, too. All right, we got 153 to go. Interesting from last night, I've never sat in nosebleed seats. It's just against my nature. And I was three rows from the top last night. Not a bad view, but the players did look like ants. But you can see how things develop, so it's interesting from that perspective. But I'd rather be up against the glass. Like, right now, you could just... Ooh, little contact. Did I hear the official yell, easy? That's right, girls. Lotas, remember. Nice, sweet, Christian ladies. Not a violent bone in your bodies. We are not thugs. Another face-off. And we are in the final minute. Almost. All right, 60 seconds to go in the second period. We are at 3-0. Does the cloth have another one in them? Hello. Hello. 39 seconds. They get excited just when they skate down to the other end, don't they? He liked to skate into a brick house, though. She's mighty, mighty. Look at that. I wouldn't want to be skating at full speed and having to run into Casey. It's got to be very frustrating, too. You're coming at her full speed, and you know the shot. Odds are it's just going to be deflected off and stop. All right, we got 9 seconds to go. Ouch. Where's that lonely little puck? It's going to be snatched from the ice. Boom. Gone in a blink of an eye. Where'd it go? Okay, at the drop of the puck, we're going to have 9 seconds. Here we go. Five, four, three, two, one. Buzzer. Thank you. 3-0 cloth. End of two. It appears I may have enough battery to finish the game. We can only hope. All the loud, obnoxious fans. And we'll come down to the other end of the ice. Watch the cloth finish out the season on a positive note. It's 3-0, starting the third period.
It does.
It's like I'm a train passing in the night. That was kind of like a view out of bus or train window, I guess, right? But the cloth is holding on to a 3-0 lead. Can we get four? I heard a whistle. I didn't know what to do with myself last night. I got home and I didn't have a video to edit. Oh, look at those breaks. Love it. Emily's making snow. She's contributing to the economy by giving a creating work for ice scoopers. Of course, this place is so cheap they don't have ice scoopers. We're lucky to get a Zamboni before the game. But we appreciate your efforts, Emily. All that break dust down there she's creating. But, uh-oh. What? So like I said, I got home last night after the Verizon game and I don't know what to do with myself. I didn't have a video to edit. It's like, what am I going to do? Put on The Walking Dead? That's always a good pastime, watching one of those creepy monster shows. That or American Horror. Good shows if you want something good to watch. But who has the time? Okay, we're at 13 minutes to go. Still 3-0. It's actually pretty cold in here today. I don't know what's going on. I don't know why it got so cold all of a sudden. I will go out, and I guess it's not going out on much of a limb, but I have confidence. The cloth has got this game sewed up. Coaches don't like to hear they talk like that, but I ain't a coach, and I am a homer. So I can say whatever I want. The cloth has this game wrapped up. And yes, I'm calling it at 12:42 in the third. Remember, in order to operate a game properly, you need one, the equipment. Two, you need the athletes. Most importantly, you need the coaches. But you've also got the periphery guys, the guys that videotape, take cameras, pictures, the photographers, and the annoying commentators, especially ones that are amateurs like the one you've been listening to all season. And when an amateur becomes a homer, it's just bad news. But it's just a matter of how many more we're going to score. Ooh. Checks out the competition. Oh, someone got blocked. Where's the puck? Where's the puck? Here we go. Off to the races. She called something for those experts. I don't know what it is. Is it another face-off down on our end? Yes, it is. A face-off on our end. Come on, Jessica. That was a tough one to handle. And I can also be a homer for my daughter. Oh, come on. Get violent in there, Jessica. Pound somebody. Shoot it. Here we go. Here we go. Fires. Wow. Lots of shots going on down here. Nice pass, Maria. Just missed. Good work, ladies. Good work. I think I deserve one of those things that you can sit in that rides you up and down the sidelines while you're sitting in a camera chair. So I don't have to stand. I deserve it. I want to be the king in one of those camera chairs that get in front of the fans' doors. I'd run it right up there in front of the noisy, obnoxious fans and block their view. And the loudest, most obnoxious opponent fan, I'd park the camera right in front of them. Show my big old butt. Saying, sorry, the camera guy must get his video. We are at 9:56, still 3-0. The ref official's going, blah, 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 blah. Nobody hears a word he's saying. Just get out of the way. Let the girls play. Took too long to shoot that one. Tough angle, tough angle. Here we go. Oh, Black intercepts it. Good pass. Nobody there. Overran it. Stop with that cowbell. Or it sounds like the consecration at Mass when the altar boy rings. Is it the altar boy that rings the bell or the priest? I don't know. You know, all you Catholics know what I'm talking about. Hello, puck. Pass to yourself. Nice job. Oh, they're getting violent against the wall. Beating each other's behinds. That's not nice. Got to delete this portion so the faculty of the cloth does not see it. Our skaters are faster than your skaters. Our skaters are faster than your skaters. Boy, they cheer loud for a shot, don't they? Right now, you're getting shut out, so shut up. Oh no. Is someone getting a detention? I don't know. I count four yellow jackets out. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, Bryn Mawr's got another girl in detention. I feel your pain. I used to get those in eighth grade all the time. Whoa. I used to get week-long detentions. And then my mother used to make me walk home from school to from St. Camillus to Calverton, about 8 miles. Then she'd feel bad for me. And I'd see her driving up and down Powder Mill Road to look for me after school when I was walking home. And to further frustrate her, believe it or not, I'd hide behind bushes and cars so when she was looking for me, she couldn't find me. Make her feel really bad for making me walk home from school. Can you believe I was a little devil? And I'd rather walk home 8 miles and upset my mother than allow myself to be found. I would hide. True story. I'm glad the two I have now are not hellions. At least not yet. Oh, almost went in. That would have been a fluke. We would have discounted that goal. Oh. Baseball. Oh wow, I almost got a souvenir. 5:41 to go. Brakes being applied. Goalie's coming too far out. Oh! Wow! Now here's where I'm thankful for the glass, because that would have probably cut my eye pretty bad. I could just feel the power as that thing hit the glass. Nice. Almost. Good work, ladies. Good work. Nice shot. Well, let's get another one here in the last 4.5 minutes, ladies. Ah, just missed. Oh. Nice move. And? Nope. Almost. Keep shooting it. Keep shooting it. What? Oh, he's calling it. He set on white. Four minutes to go. It's, they're just saying, oh, Casey's back there. Oh. Wow, vicious, vicious. Beautiful pass. Man, these cloths are tough. Haha, you were cut off at the pass. Should have shot it. You delayed. And you were stymied. Gotta be aggressive, Bryn Mawr, if you want to compete with the cloth. Otherwise, the cloth is just gonna lay on top of you and smother you with a piece of tartan. It's a wobbly puck in the corner. Well, we really don't have corners here, do we? That's not nice, Maria. You're not playing nice. Nice shot and goal. Makes four. And it looks like the homer was correct again, wasn't he? No way the cloth lose this game. What the heck? Might as well start the final countdown music now, right? Sometimes I keep forgetting that.
Yes. It's a shutout that
yes.
you well deserve.
Jessica!
Woo! Woo! Woo!
Way to go, Maureen.
Yeah!
Oh!
Nice job, coach.
Great way to end it, ladies. Beautiful. Till next year.
Nice game.